I'm Emily Davenport, and this is Techno. Today, we're going to show you how to pick a mobile data plan that actually fits your needs. Wherever you go, mobile data networks allow you to check email, browse the web, stream video, navigate by GPS, and even sync files to the cloud. But on-the-go access comes at a price. You pay for the amount of mobile data you consume. And as mobile data usage continues to grow at a rapid rate, many cellular providers are phasing out unlimited data plans because rate cap plans are, well, simply more profitable. So what's the trick to getting the most bytes for your mobile data dollar? First, determine exactly how much data you actually use. To find out your current mobile data consumption, log into your carrier's website and review your account. Most carriers provide real-time stats so you can track usage within a billing cycle. Several carriers, including AT&T and Verizon, also offer apps for monitoring account activity and SMS codes for receiving usage updates by text message. The iPhone 4S and Android devices running Ice Cream Sandwich, that's version 4.0, also have native data usage apps, but most other phones do not. There are several great third-party apps you can download with features that track usage history and send alerts when you're close to your data cap. Along with monitoring your mobile data consumption, there are several ways to manage your usage intelligently. Connect through Wi-Fi whenever possible. Why? Because data usage over Wi-Fi never counts against your plan cap. If you use a cloud service like Apple's iCloud, configure your device to sync only when connected to a Wi-Fi network. Also, turn off apps that suck data when not in active use, including location-based features that sync maps with GPS services. And if you use your smartphone as a mobile hotspot, make sure that while you're surfing the web, your laptop isn't busy downloading updates or syncing files. That will eat into your data plan significantly, as will constant instant updates from your Facebook, Twitter, and your email accounts. Apps that pull too frequently, even when there are no updates, still use small amounts of data, and over the course of a month, that can add up quickly. So setting your notifications to update every 30 minutes or even manually can greatly reduce this hidden data leak. The best way to ensure you're not overpaying for a mobile data plan is to estimate your actual data use and then pick the rate plan that's right for you. But give yourself a cushion. Overage fees can be steep. Most carriers charge for every additional megabyte over the plan cap, and some carriers are even reducing the network bandwidth available to high-volume users. Whichever mobile data plan you choose, make sure to read the fine print in your contract. That way, you know what to expect if you ever bite off more mobile data than your data plan can chew. For Techno, I'm Emily Davenport. See you next time.